Okay, now let's just see swipe view tabs in practical. For that, I'm going to create a new project. I'm going to call that project as swipe and tabs. I'm going to create it from very scratch. I'm going to select empty activity and finish. Now, in this particular practical, I'm going to create a main activity, and inside that main activity, there will be three different screens. And when I say screen, I will be creating three different fragments. And this is the practical where you learn how exactly you can create fragments also. Fragments are the sub-activities which will run inside a activity itself. Fragment cannot run on its own. They need a activity to run. So we'll see how exactly we can create the fragment also. First thing first, to access tab layout and to access your view pager, you cannot get it from a standard Android framework library. You need to get the extra library, that is design library. So we can add those design library by getting into our file, going to project structure, and then click on app, go to dependencies, and here you will be adding library dependency. And in the library dependency, look out for your design. Now it will depend upon which build version you are working with. I'm working with 25, so the design will be 25.0.01. And while your Gradle is building, now you can check out your build.gradle module app, and you can see that there is a design library now. Now you can go ahead to your layout and include those views, that is tab layout and your view pager. Let's just see the tab layout first. In Android 2.2, you don't even need to include the library externally. You get the access of tab layout in the custom design, and you just have to drag and drop. But if you are using Android 2.1 or less than 2.2, at that point of time, you have to include them manually, and you need to drag and drop now. You can do it with views, drag a view, drop it here, and search out for your tab layout. There you go. And I'll put the width as match parent and give this as ID, let's say my tab. And as you can see, this my tab is inside the relative layout, and relative layout is having a padding, so that's the reason we cannot see it merge with my action bar. So we can remove the padding here. Go back here in your XML, remove the padding. So now you can see it's merged with my action bar. Now, if you want to change the color of your tab layout, all you gotta do is go to view properties. There will be background, or you can always define it in your XML file also. So in background, you can select color primary also. So you see, now it looks, it gels good with your action bar. Now here you need to create few tabs. Now those tabs I will create when I reach to my view pager. Now let's just include one more view here, that is view pager. For that, I will again drag and drop and just call view pager. And there you go. And you can see again your view pager. I'm going to call it match parent and match parent. The other screen, the other half of the screen, I just want to fill it with the view pager, and I will call it my pager, the ID. Great. So I have my tab layout also and view pager also. Now, all I need is go to my main activity and start accessing them. Tab layout, my tab. And I would be needing a reference of my view pager also. View pager, my page, my tab equals to, again, typecast to tab layout only, and find view by ID r dot id dot, whatever the id you gave to your tab, that is my tab. Next is your view pager, that is my page, equals to view pager find view by id r dot id dot view pager. Now I have both my tab and my view pager access. Next I need is three different screens. For those three different screens, I'm going to create the fragment class. How do I do that? Well, a fragment class is just like activity, so it will be having a Java class also, and it will be having a layout file also. So either you can do that manually, create a Java class and create a layout file, or you can just go right click on your development package, go to new and go to fragment and create a blank fragment. Sorry. Here, name the fragment, let's say first, or I will call it Java fragment. Do you want to create the XML file of this? Yes, of course. Next is include fragment factory methods. No, you don't want that. And include interface callback. No, you don't want that. You want to create your fragment from the very scratch. If you check on these checkboxes right now, it will give you all the unnecessary methods which you do not require as of right now. So just click on finish and it will start including your fragment, and there you go. So there is a fragment now with the name Java, and if you really want to check it out, see the layout of this, and this is how your fragment looks like now. So indeed your fragment is nothing but just like your activity, known as sub-activity. You have a proper layout for this also and a Java file also. Now I will go ahead and change the layout of this. Let me just change the background color. And if you want to change the text part, just select your text view and call it maybe 30 SP, and call it one or Java fragment. That's it. So in the same way, this is how my first fragment looks like. So in the same way, all I need to do now is create two more fragments. Go to new, again fragment, blank fragment. Let me just call it Android. And I do not want to include factory methods and callback methods. Uncheck them, press finish. And again, I will go back to my UI part, and that is XML file. And again, I will change the layout of this. And let me just change the text also, calling it Android. Okay, let me just change the text also by calling it let's just drag and drop a text view here and match parent text size to be 30 SP and give the text to be, let's say, Android fragment. And let's just change the background color to our Android color. That is #99cc00. And let's just change the background color of our Java file. I don't want the same background color for Java also and Android also. Now we will put something nice here. Let's just go to the color and select hollow blue light. Yeah, this looks nice. There you go. So Android is done, Java is done. Now let's just include one more, just so we can see the swipe views in action. That is fragment, and make sure you choose your blank fragment. There are other types of fragment also, But as of right now, you don't need to check out those, but you can check out those fragment later part on later on. Let's just name this fragment as iOS fragment. Let's call it iOS and uncheck the factory methods and callback methods, and it will give you the third fragment. And again, change the UI part of this, change the background color. Before we change the background color, let me call it iOS fragment and change the text size to 30 SP, and go to the background and let's just put something nice to this too. Okay, orange looks good. There you go. So I have three fragments now, which are there inside my development package. All I need is a way to connect all these fragment UI to my main activity, that is inside the view page. So how can I do that? Well, to do that, first thing first is I need to create an inner class inside my main activity. That will be class my own pager adapter, which will be extending fragment pager adapter. And this is an abstract class, so I need to put the abstract methods here. So what are those abstract methods? That is get item and get count. Plus there will be a constructor which we need to override, which will need a fragment manager object as a parameter. Okay, I have my skeleton ready for the fragment manager, for the adapter class. All I need is a different string array. Let me just call it data, and I will put some array here. And this array I'm creating is I will give the title to my fragments or tabs. Okay, so here I will put iOS. Now once I do that, all I need is in my first page Java should be shown, in my second page Android should be shown, in my third page iOS should be shown. So how can I do that? For that, we have get item method, overriding method. All I need is if, I need to put the condition now, for each position, like if the position is equals to zero, that is at the very first page, you need to return which fragment, because Java is what? A fragment. So return new Java fragment, and if, let's say position is what? First, then return what? New Android. And last, if position equals to 2, that is your last position, return new iOS. There you go. So else, well, you don't even need this now, because any one of these positions, it will return one of the pages. Now, one more thing you need is for how many times, or what will be the space for your each page? What will be the size for your view pager? So what I can do for that is, just take your data dot length, because that's my array, and it is having. Okay, first of all, let's just remove the error from this, that is get item. So if it is not any one of these, you will return null. And get count is 3 times. Last is you need to set the name. So there is a method you need to override known as get page title, and it will return you what? Everything is inside data. So data and put position. So at any position you are right now, it will get the title from this particular array, and it will give it back to your view pager. So your adapter class is ready. All you have to do is set this adapter to your view pager, set adapter, and give it back, let's say new my own adapter, and here you need to pass the fragment manager object that you get by using get support fragment manager. That's it. You have your pager now. All you need is you need to sync your pager with your tab. That is my tab dot set with view set up with view pager and pass your view pager object. There you go. And once you do that, both pager and your tab are synced together. Now, if you want to put the listener for your tab also, you can always put my tab dot add on tab selected listener and put the callback new on tab selected listener, and it has three callback methods: on tab selected when you select a tab, on tab unselected when you unselect a tab, and on tab reselected when you select a tab again. So if you want to transfer to a particular pager also when you select a particular tab, just put set current item and tab dot get position, and it will transfer to that page also. And that's it. Now let's just see this in action and see the output. So there you see. So there you go. You can see that Java is your first fragment. Now if I swipe, there you go. Android is coming. And if I swipe again, iOS is coming. So this is how you implement the swipe. But if I select any tab, again, you're getting to the correct page also. So that's how you implement the swipe tabs. Thank you.